you've heard of the SAM, you've heard of ENSO, and if you haven't, where have you been hiding? Get up to speed here and here. But have you heard of the IPO? The IPO is a mysterious multi-decadal pressure pattern that influences weather. It happens over much longer timescales than El Niño, and it may have played a role in the global warming hiatus, much beloved of climate skeptics. Much like ENSO, the Inter-decadal Pacific Oscillation, or IPO, is a climate pattern that schleps warm water around the Pacific in distinct cycles. Except, unlike ENSO, it happens over much longer timescales, say 15 to 30 years. Generally, in the positive phase of the IPO, we have a much warmer tropical Pacific and a much cooler subtropical Pacific. But it's a bit more nuanced than that. In the Pacific, we have something called the South Pacific Convergence Zone, where you get loads of rainfall along a diagonal band that stretches northwest to southeast across the tropical Pacific. It basically acts as a diagonal divide between northeast and southwest and arises because of pressure differences between different parts of the Pacific Ocean. So, let's take the positive phase of the IPO to explain this. All you got to remember is that the negative phase is the opposite. In the positive phase of the IPO, much like with ENSO, we get warm water in the eastern Pacific, which causes the air immediately above it to rise, creating areas of lower pressure. On the other side of the Pacific, in the west, we get higher pressure, because the air is descending and the ocean temperature is cooler. That pattern of warm water in the east and cool water in the west generates more southerly flow than usual over the Pacific basin. Because you get more deep convection in areas where the sea is warm and the air is rising rapidly, you get more precipitation. So northeast of the South Pacific Convergence Zone, you get lots more rain, whereas southwest, you get lots less. In other words, you intensify the South Pacific Convergence Zone. Now, some scientists aren't convinced that the IPO is an actual thing, and they think that it's probably just a combination of other things, maybe a slow-moving component of ENSO, or possibly even just noise. Part of that is because there isn't a specific mechanism that is known to drive the IPO, although there are some ideas about that. One such idea is that the IPO is at least partly governed by slow-moving circulation in the ocean, which moves at a fraction of the pace that the atmosphere does. But that's pretty hard to test. Some studies even suggest that variations might be related to atmospheric aerosol concentrations. Other people, including respected scientists like Michael Mann, suggest it's really just unpredictable and random changes from one phase to another, essentially just noise, although noise that sort of has inertia and therefore resembles something more mechanistic. Still others are convinced it's basically just leftover ENSO signals. But whatever causes it, the IPO influences how big the effects of other climate patterns are on different parts of the world. So for example, in Australia, during the negative phase of the IPO, you get much more intense weather associated with El Niños. In the positive phase of the IPO, an El Niño of the same strength would have a comparatively lesser effect. So I guess you can think of the IPO as a magnifier or a dampener that turns the dial up or down on existing climate patterns. But of course, just to be difficult, whether the dial goes up or down depends on where you are in the world. Classic. Although the specifics of what gets dialed up or down depends on location, generally the positive phase of the IPO tends to increase global mean temperature rise, whereas the negative phase tends to minimise warming. Some scientists have even suggested that the IPO has influenced global mean temperatures since the beginning of the 21st century enough to explain the global warming hiatus, or global pause, so much beloved of climate deniers. If you've not heard of these terms, I'll bring you up to speed. Around about the early 2000s, the previously steep rate of temperature rise, aka global warming, that we'd been observing had started to slow. And of course, this was used as ammunition by climate deniers to attack climate science. Now, there are a whole bunch of complex factors influencing what caused this hiatus, but it does seem plausible that something that dials up or down existing patterns and trends could be at least partly responsible. The idea is that because we've had a more negative IPO in recent decades, that has allowed much more heat to be stored deep down in the Pacific Ocean, which has slowed the overall rate of climate change. If that flips to a more positive IPO, that would change and the rate of warming would probably accelerate. So if we're due a positive IPO pretty soon and we're about to dial up the effect of emissions-driven warming, I guess we probably better dial down the old climate change, eh? Lastly, I just wanted to say thank you and give a big shout out to all my new Patreon subscribers. And if you like my videos and you want to join them, you can do that by the link I'm putting in the video description.